Rangers beating the Toronto Maple Leafs. New York Rangers hockey on MSG Networks is presented by Chase. Hello, everyone. Welcome to New York Rangers hockey. Sam Rose along with Joe Micheletti. And you've never seen people more happy to see an American-based team in your life. They were so happy to see the Rangers come in to play the Maple Leafs.
And you thought it was you that they were happy to see. But no, Sheldon Keith, the head coach for the Toronto Maple Leafs, was telling us this morning. He said in our all-Canadian division last year, there was no reason to watch the rest of the league. So they just watched the Canadian team. So he said now, getting ready for the Rangers to come up here, they had to spend a lot of work to get prepared for this game.
Rangers coming off a big win. Their first win of the season. They're 1-1-1. They played very well in Montreal. The negative of the night was an injury to Kaapo Kakko. Yeah. And along with that, Ryan Strome remains out in COVID protocol. So two-thirds of one of the Rangers' top lines is out of the lineup.
It's hard to make up when you lose two of your top six forwards. And we talked about the loss of Strome the other night, how important that is, especially with that combination he has with Panarin. But then you've got Kaapo Kakko. You just see the improvement in him throughout the preseason and what he's done. So now you lose him, and that puts a lot of onus and pressure on other parts of your game. Either other players have to score to make up for that, or you've got to play excellent defensive hockey in order to make up maybe for the lack of scoring.
The top line for the Rangers remains intact with Mika Zibanejad centering Chris Kreider and Alexis Lafreniere. The second line now becomes Artemi Panarin on the left, but in the middle, Filippito, who played there on Saturday night, and on the right, Barclay Goodrow.
Well, you know, Sam, we've talked a lot about Barclay Goodrow. He's such a good story, an undrafted player that's gotten to these heights in the National Hockey League with a couple of Stanley Cups and a six-year contract with the Rangers. And we've discussed, and other people have talked about, his ability to play in different parts of the lineup. He can play a checking role. He can kill penalties. But he's got enough talent and know-how with his game where you can move him up in the lineup where he can take play with top players. So the importance of having a Barclay Goodrow in the lineup right now is really important. And I would only expect him to play another good game because he's such a reliable player.
But there is offensive pressure on that top line, Zibanejad, Kreider, and Lafreniere. But they're all three playing very well. Lafreniere had a terrific game. Everybody thrilled with that. Chris Kreider with a goal in each of the first three games. And Mika Zibanejad, a strong two-way game Saturday night.
The only thing that Mika Zibanejad hasn't done yet in these first three games is score a goal. And you know that he's going to break out any time here with the way he shoots the puck and the amount of time that he's had the puck. He was absolutely fabulous against Montreal and didn't have a goal. He did have chances. The Rangers power play had chances. But throughout the game, when Zibanejad had a chance to find open ice, boy, he just turned on the power and the speed and turned it into something, including this one right there. The Rangers needed that goal after Montreal came back. It was a quick response. Lafreniere, as you mentioned, Sam, was good in that game, and he had the game winner.
The other factor Saturday night, it was a great goaltending matchup. Jake Allen, excellent for Montreal, but Igor Shesterkin really stood out for the Rangers.
Well, I thought when you asked Benoit Allaire before the game tonight, when we ran into him, about what stood out in his game, and he said just the way he read the plays, and I thought, yeah, I wish I would have thought of that. All we kept saying was how good he was, but he just seemed to be in the right spot for just about every shot, no matter what. His awareness of where the puck was good all night, but his ability to just get to the right spots and knowing where the puck was going to be, knowing where the opposition was. And Steve Alakette talked about this along with Henrik on the pregame show about the important saves that he had to make in that game, particularly the second half, and he was in the right spots to make the big saves when he had to.
Toronto Maple Leafs 2-1 to start the season, and they've done that without one of the best players in the National Hockey League in Austin Matthews. He is back tonight to make his season debut, and guy has awesome numbers, Joe.
you look at all those, and one goal away from 200, Sam, and led the league in goals last year, and this is a guy that can just do it all.
I don't know. How do you defend a player like that?
I don't know. You don't.
I don't think
you hope you outscore him, I think. But, you know, when you think of him, he's got just a fabulous fabulous wrist shot, maybe the best wrist shot in all of hockey. But there's so much more to his game than that. So he can beat you from the outside. He's got the size and strength to go to the front of the net. And, oh, yeah, don't forget about the great hands he's got also. He had wrist surgery in the middle of August, so he's missed the first three games. But he's been raring to go, and Rangers are going to have to pay a lot of attention to him tonight.
And these Maple Leafs have a lot of offensive talent. One of them is William Nylander, signed a big contract a couple of years ago. Yeah. He's got plenty of talent,
You know, he's 25 now. He's been their best player this year thus far. And I like what Brendan Shanahan told us this morning. He said, well, you know, when we signed this kid to the contract, everybody said, you overpaid for him. He can't play. Now he's 25. He's their best player. And everybody's saying, boy, what a great contract you signed him to. And he can skate. And he wants the puck. And you know what? He was excellent in the playoffs last year, Sam, for this team. And you know what? He's turning into a man. He's 25 now. Knows what it takes in this league. He's a top player.
Well, it's good to be back in Canada. They're happy to see the Rangers. This sets up a terrific matchup. Lots of talent like Mitch Marner. His speed, his scoring ability. Rangers have to worry about that. We talked about Chris Kreider. Off to a great start. A goal in each of the first three games. Rangers and Leafs are next. You need to hire. You need Indeed. Here in Toronto, getting set for the Rangers and Toronto Maple Leafs. Let's check out our Audi goaltending matchup. Well, there is Austin Matthews first, making his season debut. And there are the goaltenders tonight. Igor Shesterkin in his third start. And 1-0-1, the overtime loss to Dallas, the win in Montreal. Jack Campbell, who had 17 wins last season for Toronto, is off to a good start, 2-0, and Austin Matthews on the ice, Joe, ready to go.
Yeah, he talked yesterday about how excited he's been, how difficult it was to sit and watch his team play and watch all the fun they were having on the ice. So he's back in there for the first game of the season.
Toronto opened up with a win over Montreal, 2-1, lost to Ottawa, and then beat Ottawa. That's Nick Ritchie, number 20, feeding Austin Matthews, and a good play by Adam Fox. And the Rangers send it down the ice, and this is an icing on the Rangers in the opening minute. Rangers opening up with Fox and Lindgren on defense.
Well, Matthews, you know, right away, opening faceoff. The Leafs get it in, and then he makes a couple of real good plays to keep the play alive. Loses it here. Watch how he'll make the play, and then he dives there. That keeps the play alive, and eventually that forces the Rangers into an icing, and Toronto takes the opportunity to put a fresh line on the ice.
Rangers change lines, but they wanted to change lines, but they can't because they ice the puck again.
Another icing. That's only 32 seconds, though, so that group that's on the ice that started the game by no means should be stressed. And there's the head coach of the Toronto Maple Leafs, Sheldon Keefe. He's really worked with this team the last couple seasons to turn them into a better defensive-minded team.
Nice play by Kreider as he carries down. Backhander by Kreider, his glove by Campbell. John Tavares is on, number 91, with William Nylander. And Michael Bunting, number 58, a local product.
Rangers hard-working
have
kid.
A couple of local products in the lineup. Barkley Goodrow is a local product, grew up in the Toronto area. And he's got family and friends here tonight.
He just took a penalty also.
Oh.
He tried to slow down William Nylander and ended up getting the stick up high and clipped him. And so Barkley Goodrow will head to the penalty box. And that's one thing the Rangers didn't want to do. Here you see it right here. The puck kind of goes up his arm. He had him on the arm, and William Nylander, watch what he does with his arm. He raises his arm. The stick comes up as well and just barely catches him. And so Goodrow with an early penalty, and the Rangers have to face what is a very good Toronto power play,
sure,
especially when you have Austin Matthews back in the lineup.
They're 3-for-11 to start the season. Rangers' penalty kill was perfect on Saturday night. They are 7-for-11 thus far this season on the penalty kill. Rangers have Zibanejad with Greg McKay. Adam Fox and Ryan Lindgren. Rangers able to clear. Riley back for it for Toronto. Chris Kreider has come on with Kevin Rooney. Austin Matthews is on the power play. The puck brought in by Nylander. Here is John Tavares, number 91. Riley to Matthews, back to Riley. Morgan Riley. Austin Matthews with a shot off the glove of Shesterkin. Tavares able to get it to Nylander. The pass deflects out. Matthews there to keep it in. Mitch Marner. Austin Matthews shoots, save, Bates to Shesterkin. Wow, that's a dangerous shot. Matthews looking strong already. Takes the pass, beats Nylander, gets it back. Down low, that was tipped by Fox. Lindgren trying to bat it ahead. Tied up with Matthews. Riley with Kreider on him. Nylander out to Riley. A wrister that's deflected into the corner. This unit has been on for a long time right now. There's Nylander. The Leafs have been able to keep the puck in the Rangers' zone. The setup for Nylander. A stick save made by Shesterkin. Riley again. Quick pass for Nylander. Kreider on him. Fox trying to take it away. Does. Fires around the boards. Marner is there to keep it in. That pass deflects to Kreider. He softly dumps it down the ice. And the Rangers have survived.
Yeah, he had absolutely nothing left. Nor did the other three players that were on the ice with him.
Team's back at full strength. Two shots on goal for the Leafs. Driving hard to net, and it was put in front. Hedl cleared it away. Hedl on with Goodrow and Panarin. Trouba and Miller. That's Kerfoot, number 15, pressuring Miller. Hedl away with a puck. And the lead to Goodrow. He's checked there by Rasmus Sandin, number 38. Puck deflects back. Rangers take possession. And the shot by Patrick Nemeth was blocked. And that hurt on the block. Back forward is Nemeth.
Andre Kasha.
It was Andre Kasha.
Yeah.
Battle for the puck in front of the Rangers bench. A little over 4 minutes gone by here in the first period. Leafs come in again. Wayne Simmons, the veteran forward. The shot went off his skate. Scored a goal on Saturday night in the win over Ottawa. Simmons, who played so many years in Philadelphia. Now back in his hometown. Trouba, long pass intended for Dryden Hunt, who's tipped away. Riley back court, swings it around the board. Rangers get there. Kevin Rooney. Rooney on with Julien Gauthier. Gauthier was really disappointed he didn't get to play in Montreal, but he's happy about being back tonight. That was blocked in front by Jake Muzzin. And now Morgan Riley. 5 minutes gone by here in the first. Rangers being physical. Sammy Blais with a good hit on Nick Ritchie in center. Ritchie has taken the place of Zach Hyman, who was a big player on one of their top lines.
Yeah. Now it's tough to step into those shoes. Hyman, a hardworking player that had some skating speed to his game. You know, gave you some grit, also could score some, and just an all-round player.
Ryan Lindgren sends it in for the Rangers off the stick of Jack Campbell. Riley was able to move it up to Tavares. Chipped ahead by Michael Bunting. Bunting, who scored a goal Saturday night. It was a big moment for him. He joins his local team. Team he rooted for as a kid. Hall sends it across. Justin Hall and Jake Muzzin, the defensive pair. Muzzin will help the LA Kings win the Stanley Cup, couple of Stanley Cups. Deals Lundqvist with a pass across to Panarin. Sandin checks him. Nice pass off the post. Nils. Oh, Nils Lundqvist rang one off the post. He just missed.
Boy, what a pass from Panarin. Backhand pass, and Lundqvist wasted no time. And the goaltender was on the other side. He had him beaten, but just off the post.
6.5 minutes gone by. First period, Rangers and Maple Leafs, no score.
Nils Lundqvist nearly had his first NHL goal. Beautiful pass here. Here's the backhand pass from Panarin. Lundqvist wasted no time, and you can see Jack Campbell, the goaltender, wasn't quite over that other side, so there was room on the short side, and Lundqvist off the post and out.
Interesting little side note here, Joe. Nils Lundqvist, 28th pick in the first round in 2018 by the Rangers. The next pick, the 29th, was Sandin. Rasmus Sandin of the Maple Leafs to the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Yeah, I was talking to Brendan Shanahan about that this morning, and so they took a good look at Nils Lundqvist. They just weren't sure which one they were going to get. Both similar players, somewhat undersized, both think the game extremely well, and so either one they were going to be happy with, and Sandin has played pretty well for the Maple Leafs.
He's played a little more than Lundqvist has. Lundqvist now in his third NHL game. Sandin has had a few more games in the NHL. I believe it's 40. Coming in with a shot, save made. That's David Kampf, who took the shot on Shesterkin.
Yeah, Kampf came over from the Chicago Blackhawks, where he had played, and had a pretty good opportunity there, and Shesterkin just coolly and calmly put himself in position to glove that shot. And there's the head coach, Gerard Gallant, to the New York Rangers.
And congratulations to him on his first win as a coach of the Rangers on Saturday night. That was a big moment.
And yep.
I think everyone was reveling in the Lafreniere part of the story. And don't want to forget the head coach. Sandin is on for Toronto, number 38. Able to work it deep. Rangers have Ryan Lindgren on defense with Adam Fox. Here's Rasmus Sandin. Long shot blocked in front by Lindgren. That's a backhander in front, intercepted by Fox. Rangers break out 4-on-3. Sammy Blais dropped it off. Kevin Rooney's pass broken up. Nice defensive play by Travis Dermott. Back the other way, Wayne Simmonds, with Pierre Engvall, number 47, on the ice as well. And the veteran, Jason Spezza. He's still going strong, Joe.
He's played well for Toronto.
Yes.
They just keep signing him to new contracts. He's played so well.
Here's Simmonds. Open man with Jake Muzzin, but he missed the pass. Austin Matthews lost control. Lundqvist tried to clear it. It was kept in by Marner. He's quick. Around the boards, Nemeth is there. That's blocked by Hall. Nemeth trying to play it. Got it through. Pass to Banajed. Marner works it ahead. Here's Matthews against Nemeth. One hands the pass to Nick Ritchie. That went through Marner. Played by Jake Muzzin. Toward the net. Blocked in front by Nemeth. Now Ritchie. And Matthews with Zibanejad on him. That's a good matchup. Leafs controlling the puck well. Ball finds a man. It's Austin Matthews, and he missed wide, and the puck all the way back.
Yeah, that was one of the things that the coaching staff was telling the forwards in back in their defensive zone. Toronto really likes to move around a lot, so you forwards have to really get on those forwards, and you could see it that last shift.
You could hear the crowd. There's a shot taken by Bunting and a nice save by Shesterkin. The crowd, in anticipation of Matthews taking the shot, they took a deep breath and then were disappointed when the shot missed. Here comes William Nylander. He turns, drops it back. T.J. Brody, the former Calgary Flame, playing it deep. Truba works it up the boards and out of the zone. Brody gets to it. And Morgan Rielly. Brody pass ahead. Alexander Kerfoot. And David Kampf, Kampf 64. Burford, number 15. And Andre Kasho signed as a free agent. Number 25 on for Toronto. That's lifted across for Panarin. And offside whistled on the play. 10-11 to go here in the first period. There's no score in the game.
Well, Matthews has had some chances in this game. This is the one you were just talking about, Sam, where he took the shot right off the pass. And then John Tavares with a little drop pass led to a good opportunity. That was Bunting that had that shot. And Shesterkin has been steady to start this game. Shots 4-3 favoring Toronto.
Matthews and Hedl for the faceoff. Matthews wins it. Muzzin played it across. Hall playing it toward the net. It hit Nick Ritchie. Ritchie, number 20. That shot saves Shesterkin on the shot by Ritchie. Ritchie got some offense going in his game Saturday night. He's a physical player. Shesterkin off to a good start. There's no score. Scored a goal in his NHL debut on today's date in 1952. Tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac Trivia. 9:58 to go. Just past the midway point, first period. Both teams skating well. A couple of chances for each side.
Yeah, I think if anything for the Rangers, I think Gerard Gallant would like to see his team get their forecheck going, and they really haven't spent much time in the Toronto zone as of yet.
Jacob Trouba off the boards to Artemi Panarin. Patrick Nemeth gets to it. Hedl goes to the front of the net. The backhander was stopped by Campbell. Wayne Simmonds for Toronto with Jason Spezza and Pierre Engvall. Engvall, number 47. He's tied up by Patrick Nemeth. Lundqvist moving it up the boards and all the way down. No icing. And Riley back for it. Good pressure by Barkley Goodrow. Goodrow brought the Stanley Cup here to Toronto during the summer. Went to a children's hospital, a golf course, naturally.
Yeah.
And ended up in a restaurant downtown. And said by the end of the day, he was really tired.
Worn out from carrying that Stanley Cup around.
Yeah, that 36-pound trophy. Here's Dryden Hunt. He's checked there by Travis Dermott. And they wrestle a little bit after the whistle, and things settle down.
Now a good outlet pass by Jacob Trouba to get the Rangers going. Here comes the pass. Good job, and Hunt does a nice job here just trying to get to the net. And Travis Dermott does a good job defensively, not watching the puck, taking the man. So he takes Hunt out. Hunt keeps trying to get his position, and Dermott didn't want to give in. Good job by both players.
8:46 to go in the first. Faceoff win by David Kampf, cleared out by Muzzin. Kerfoot lost it. That is played by Adam Fox. Lindgren were able to work it ahead. Lafreniere, good pass. Shot, save made, and it's cleared out of the crease by Muzzin. Good shot by Chris Kreider. Lindgren trying to keep it in. Kasha able to get it out to David Kampf. Off the corner boards, Lindgren. Now Adam Fox. Fox with a point in each of the first three games. Kampf sends it wide of the net. Off the corner boards, chases down, chips it in front. Mitch Marner there. Rangers have Rooney, Sammy Blais, and Julian Gauthier on. There's Rooney. Sammy Blais was stopped by Travis Dermott. Fired ahead by Lundqvist. That deflects the Blais. Blais moves in. Gauthier goes to the net. Cuts in, and it was poked away. As he tried to stick handle to the backhand, it was poke checked away.
Yeah, by Campbell. Boy, he made a good play. It's a strong move again by Gauthier. We saw him have plenty of those types of chances during the preseason.
Dermott, back pass to Sandin. Goodrow on the forecheck. 7 minutes to go, first period. No score in the game. Heedle leads Goodrow. Left it for Panarin. Steered away by Campbell. Trouba able to play it. Tipped out of the zone. DeAndre Miller going for it. That's Engvall moving it across to Riley. Back the other way for Spezza. Miller's pass blocked. Miller again goes to Trouba, and out it goes. Panarin. Tipped ahead by Goodrow and stopped by Campbell. Morgan Riley there to play it. Riley fires hard around the boards. Fox gets to it and reverses. Greg McKegg on with Ryan Reeves and Dryden Hunt. McKegg is the local product. Sabanajet with a shot off the post. Second post, and that shot from a sharp angle was steered up into the netting by Campbell. Rangers coming close again.
Boy, that was a strange. When he took the shot, I thought it was in, Sam.
Rangers think it's in. Let's see.
Let's see where it goes. It is. It hit the post and then the middle part and then out. This is going to count. You see see that middle part up high? So here the watch goes off the post and then it deflects in, hits the camera inside the net up high. You'll see it here again. Boom! And out that quickly. Even Jack Campbell, the goaltender, I think, might have, it was a strange sound.
Yeah.
And so they're going to look. This will be Zibanejad's first goal of the game of the season.
Isn't right. Mika Zibanejad gives the Rangers a 1-0 lead. And gets a pat on the back for a terrific shot.
Well, the Rangers on the aggressive forecheck. Campbell comes out. That was Ryan Reeves that got in there quickly. And eventually the Rangers forced a turnover, and coming off the bench was Zibanejad, and he just walked into it and fired that wrist shot and scores his first of the year, and the Rangers take the lead. Sam, once the Rangers are able to kill that early penalty, and then a couple more shifts it took them to get going, and then they started putting a little bit more pressure and playing a little bit more in the Toronto zone and getting that, you know, that flow back to their game. And it turns out to be, you know, it all worked here because they forced a turnover and Zibanejad scores.
His first of the season, he has 4 points and points in 3 straight games. Nylander fanned on the shot attempt. Taken back by Lafreniere. Just under 6 minutes to go, first period. Here comes Zibanejad again. Pass in front intended for Lafreniere. He was checked by Hall. Zibanejad bumped into Lafreniere and went down. The Leafs the other way. That shot by Bunting, a save made by Shesterkin, and he holds it with 5:33 to go in the first period. The Rangers have scored first on Mika Zibanejad's first of the season. That man is not a rookie. He's got a lot of experience. And man, can he shoot the puck.
Yeah, he had another chance to shoot it right after that and tried to hit Lafreniere as he did against Montreal, breaking down the left wing and just missed on that connection.
Rangers able to push the puck out of the zone. Gauthier after it. Was picked off by Morgan Riley. Long pass goes down the ice. It's an icing on the Leafs. 5:20 to go. Zibanejad's goal is unassisted at 13:53. Zibanejad with 4 points on the season. There is Alexi Lafreniere.
Yeah, Ryan Reeves won't, you know, is not getting an assist, as you mentioned, unassisted goal, but he was the first man in. He forced the goaltender, Jack Campbell, to get rid of it, and then he went where the puck was passed and put pressure on that, and eventually they forced the Leafs into making a bad pass, and Zibanejad read it and scored.
Gauthier made a good play in the corner. His pass was intercepted by Mitch Marner. Nick Ritchie, now Mitch Marner. The trailer, Matthews moves down with the puck. Austin Matthews. Back pass to Riley. TJ Brody shot off the skate of Nick Ritchie, and Sammy Blais finds it. Nick Ritchie, who played with the Boston Bruins last season, signed as a free agent with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Riley. David Camp moves in, and Reeves stays with him. Reeves shoved him down. Patrick Demuth after it. Perfect for the back pass. Jake Muzzin. Perfect along the boards. Now Demuth. Jared Tenorti and Libor Hayek healthy scratches for the Rangers, along with Morgan Barron, who was called up. With Capo Caco going on IR with an upper body injury. And the Rangers still without Ryan Strome, who is in COVID protocol and unavailable for tonight's game. Jason Spezza. Now Wayne Simmonds with a lead for Engvall, Pierre Engvall. Spezza to Simmonds, just missed wide. Some good passing by the Leafs. Engvall. Checked by Trouba. And a penalty upcoming on the Rangers. Rangers touch up. And they will be shorthanded on a hooking call to Jacob Trouba.
Yeah, that's a good sustained offensive zone shift by the Toronto Maple Leafs. And Simmonds had a real good chance and just missed. And they just kept up the pressure, and eventually Trouba ends up taking the penalty. Here's the passing play, and there's Simmonds, and it looked like a save, just getting a piece of it with his glove, with Shesterkin. And then in the corner, there you see the number 8 in white is Jacob Trouba. He takes the hooking penalty, second power play of the game for Toronto.
Leafs had 2 shots on goal on their first. Tavares won the faceoff. Riley gets it back from Nylander. Rangers have McKegg, Zibanejad, Fox, and Lindgren. That pass blocked by Lindgren. Good play. And it was gloved side of the net by Shesterkin.
Yeah, it's an excellent stick by Lindgren, because in front was John Tavares was in front all alone. And 55 in white. Just watch how he reacts. The puck will come. 16 will move over to the left side. He'll end up with it and try and make a quick pass in front. And there's the stick of Lindgren. Does a nice job, and then Shesterkin able to cover up.
Face-off win again by Tavares. Leafs win a lot of face-offs, and Tavares is a big reason why. Austin Matthews set up Marner. His shot was blocked. Rangers have Rooney on with Barkley Goodrow. Matthews tried to go to the net. Here's Marner. Pass from Tavares, trying to hit Nylander. Shot by Riley, save, and the rebound up into the netting. 1:20 to go in the Leafs power play.
Did you know you can still place live bets during the game? From props to over-unders, make every moment more on the FanDuel Sportsbook app.
Barkley Goodrow. Getting penalty killing time has become an important penalty killer for the Rangers.
Rangers done a really good job with their sticks on the penalty kill, and even at even strength in their own zone, deflecting a lot of passes and shots.
Here's Marner, looks toward the net, his shot deflected by Nemeth out of play. Rangers have McKegg and Zibanejad, Nemeth and Miller.
Yeah, good job again. Marner looking for his first goal of the season. Head up all the way, tries to get it through, and Nemeth has a nice job deflecting that into the netting.
Marner has played over 350 NHL games and has averaged just about a point a game, just under a point a game. Tavares, Marner, open man, Nylander saves Shesterkin. Oh, great save by Shesterkin. Here comes Keandre Miller with Mika Zibanejad. Off the stick, Zibanejad winds it around the boards. And Austin Matthews takes over. Driving to the net, Nylander off the post. And the Leafs have hit a post. And that shot off the post as well by Spezza. In comes Nylander toward the net, check from behind. Leafs putting big time pressure on. Spezza down low, Matthews. That was blocked by Keandre Miller up into the netting. 17 seconds remaining in the power play.
Well, the Rangers had a 2-on-1 and missed that opportunity, and then their Leafs come right back down. And Marner with the pass, Nylander off the post. Nylander again, there it is, off the post on the short side. So they hit a couple of posts during that opportunity, during that power play. Rangers not quite there yet, 17 seconds remaining.
There's Sandin with a shot, deflected away. Shesterkin might have gotten a piece. That pass intercepted by Kreider, breaks out with Goodrow. Chris Kreider against Jake Muzzin. Good effort by Kreider to carry it deep. Now it's Barkley Goodrow along the boards. Power play is over. Rangers penalty kill, 2 for 2 in the game. They were 3 for 3 Saturday night. Goodrow tried to take it away from Bunting. This is Nick Ritchie moving in. His pass is grabbed away by Lindgren. Fox hit the referee with the pass. Here's Kreider firing it off the skates of Lafreniere. 1 minute to go, first period. TJ Brody moves in. Rangers leading 1-0 on the goal by Mika Zibanejad. Andre Kasha's shot saves Shesterkin. 12 shots on goal for the Leafs. And Shesterkin has beaten a couple of beauties. And he has been solid from the start. Down the boards, Truba's there. 30 seconds to go in the period. Barkley Goodrow's pass blocked by Engvall, who takes it back.
25 seconds. 25.
Camp moving it across.
20.
Here's TJ Brody. Off the corner boards, Austin Matthews fires right through the crease. Rangers take over. Panarin. Little pass to Hedel. Fired across, off the board. Truba's shot blocked, deflects wide of the net. Panarin swings it in front. That's the period. Leafs 12 shots, Rangers 10. Rangers penalty killing 2 for 2.
Yeah.
And Mika Zibanejad with the only goal.
Well, that's when Toronto was able to get their best chances, is either on the power play or just after the power play, where they kept that momentum going. And then once the Rangers were able to get away from that, then the Rangers were able to get some offensive chances of their own.
Rangers head off with a 1-0 lead here in Toronto. Coming up, it's the first intermission report, brought to you by your local Honda dealers. John Gianone joins us, and Barkley Goodrow will be his special guest. Bill Pito has the MSG 150, and then Henrik Lundqvist and Steve Valiquette get together for analysis of the first period. Rangers in Toronto. Igor Shesterkin coming off last Saturday night's win. And he's off to a good start with 12 saves. Mika Zibanejad scored his first goal of the season. Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Getting set for the second period, Rangers and Maple Leafs. New York Rangers hockey on MSG Networks is presented by Chase. How about Igor Shesterkin picking right up, Joe?
Yeah, he sure did, Sam. Good again. 12 shots for Toronto in that first period. Shesterkin able to stop all 12. The guys in the studio were talking about some of those where he was able to see it. The people in front of him gave him a clear view of some of those shots by Austin Matthews and others. But there were a few other ones where he didn't have a clear view and still was able to come up with the save. Toronto also hit the post a couple of times, but another very solid period for Igor Shesterkin.
And Joe, I know these statistics can be skewed a little bit, but the Rangers came into tonight's game leading the league with 82 hits, and they had 13 in the first period.
It was, and it, hey, Sam, that was very apparent. The Rangers were hitting everything. They did. They finished all their checks. They were led by Reaves had three, so he led the way. The other thing that stood out to me, Sam, on a positive side, was the Rangers forced Toronto into 9 turnovers in that first period, including the only goal.
Lafreniere picks up the puck after Austin Matthews had a shot blocked. Rangers with Zibanejad, Kreider, and Lafreniere. Lafreniere weaves his way in. Good rush down the ice. Austin Matthews there to take it away, looking for some room. Mitch Marner, and Zibanejad takes it back. Lafreniere playing it off the boards. Marner goes for it. Kreider after it. Jake Muzzin dropped it off. Marner's pass ahead to Nick Ritchie. And Justin Hall with the outlet to Ritchie. Marner looks and shoots. Deflection and save by Shesterkin.
That was not a good change by the Rangers. All three forwards changed when Toronto was going up the ice and allowed them a 3-on-2.
Panarin passed through to the cutting. Trouba went off his skate. Leafs able to clear it out. Marner dumps it in the Rangers zone. Tavares after it. Trouba is there. And it's played by Keandre Miller. Goodrow and Riley. DJ Brody was able to work it ahead. Leafs come out with it. Here's Riley, the defenseman, coming forward. Riley goes in, looks toward the net, and that's steered away. They score! And maybe Bunting again. He scored Saturday night. He was at the post, and it looked like it tipped in off of him.
Now, Morgan Riley led the rush, the defenseman. And as he got pushed to the outside, all he did was just throw the puck at the net. And Bunting was going there. It seemed to just, everybody seemed to lose the puck momentarily. Here's Riley, and he'll just put it at the net. And I'm not sure, you know, Bunting was there. Did he reach out with the left skate? I don't think so.
At it with the stick,
yeah, I think
Joe.
He got it with his stick first, and I think it just deflected around a little bit. Did he kick the pad? Now here's going to be interesting, because he kicked the left pad of Shesterkin. No, it's not going to be interesting because they no challenge.
Nope.
They dropped it. They elected not to challenge.
The coaches looked at the video and said, "Let's play on." So the Leafs have tied it. Michael Bunting, who played last season in Arizona. Driving to the net, Kevin Rooney is taken down, a penalty called. Rangers will get a power play. 2 minutes into the second period. Rooney was tripped up.
Yeah, quick response, real good move by Rooney. Rangers get it up the ice in a hurry. Rooney threw the puck into an area, went to get it, and gets taken down. And so the Rangers go on the power play after Toronto came back to tie the game.
Rangers 2-for-13 this season on the power play. They go with Zibanejad, Kreider, Lafreniere, Panarin, and Fox. The Leafs penalty kill 8-for-10 this season. This Rangers power play brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers. The Leafs have dominated faceoffs in this game.
Yeah, they have. They've been good all season and the early part of the season, but 15-4 in the first period. That's domination, Sam. And Matthews was 5-0 and Tavares was 6-2.
After the clear, fans cheer the local product, Michael Bunting. Morgan Riley and John Tavares getting the assists on the Bunting goal to tie the game. Rangers haven't been able to get in the zone and set up. Here comes Panarin. His pass blocked and again blocked and cleared by Hall. There was an offside whistled on the Rangers. So a little choppy on this power play.
Jam, here's another look at the goal. The puck just comes to the front. Bunting gets a piece of it. It hits Shesterkin. Shesterkin doesn't know where it is and eventually just deflects in, and that tied the game at a goal apiece.
Second unit comes on for the Rangers. Hedl, Dryden Hunt, Sammy Blay, who is looking for the puck, Niels Lundqvist, and Jacob Trouba. 1 minute to go on the power play. The Rangers have been unable to get anything going thus far. That comes all the way down, stopped by Campbell, plays it off the glass, blocked by Sammy Blay. And Morgan Riley tried to take it away. Good play by Lundqvist on the keep in. Here's Niels Lundqvist. Now Trouba missed his shot. The rebound played off the side of the net by Hedl, then around the boards. And out comes Engvall. Pierre Engvall got knocked down by Blay, but cleared it all the way down. Trouba heads up ice. Trouba fires in around the boards. Jake Muzzin gets to it. He's tied up there by Dryden Hunt. Lundqvist is there. Hunt trying to dig it free, does, but gave it up to David Camp. And out comes Andre Kasha to clear. And that will do it. Rangers didn't get anything going on that power play.
For the first half, Sam, they kept trying to carry the puck in the zone. That didn't work. They're very reluctant to shoot it in and go after it.
Teams at full strength. Good rush down the ice by Fox, who backhands it around the boards. And out comes Dick Ritchie. Lafreniere is back. And Fox gets back to intercept. A little over 4 minutes gone by. 4:15 gone by here in the second. Austin Matthews, checked from behind by Greg McKay. Lindgren took a hit from Ritchie, but moved the puck. Fox's pass off the skate, picked up by McKay. Greg McKay, originally a Toronto Maple Leafs draft pick, coming into the NHL. Good hit on Sandin by Reeves. Zibanejad, Reeves, and Goodrow on for the Rangers. Zibanejad forced a turnover. Goodrow around to Zibanejad. Reeves in the corner. Goodrow looking for it. Still alive. Reeves moves it. Comes out in front. The Leafs able to come out. Marner had it knocked away by Keandre Miller. Goodrow sends it in. 5:15 gone by in the second. Pressure on Travis Dermott. Tavares got knocked down by Goodrow. And the puck recovered by Lundqvist. Patrick Nemeth lifts it in. And Travis Dermott gets to it.
Goodrow now playing on a line with Zibanejad and Kreider. Kreider moves back to the left side. Goodrow on the right.
That's an icing on the Leafs. 5:42 gone by here in the second period. And the game tied 1-1. Well, Michael Bunting has a smile on his face the entire game.
Yeah,
so
well,
he's just loving being here in Toronto.
What a thrill for him. Now, Sam, this next line, Sammy Blay now has been moved up with Panarin and Hedl.
Right.
Some line shuffling for the Rangers.
Bunting out with it. Shesterkin plays the puck. That's blocked by Tavares. Bunting for Tavares. That's moved by Lundqvist. And Sammy Blay is there. Now Lundqvist, long outlet to Panarin. Panarin looking. Backhands it around the boards. Jason Spezza gets to it. Rangers take it back. Hedl battling Morgan Riley. Spezza is there. So is Blay. Lindgren to Blay. Blay checked by Riley. Now Hedl with a pass to Fox toward the net, tipped wide. Panarin. Panarin fires it in front. It's deflected. And the Leafs couldn't control. Panarin has it back. In the Rangers zone. Wayne Simmons saves Shesterkin. Simmons quick to the puck. And Simmons got wrapped up by Lindgren. 6:49 gone by, second period. The Leafs have scored a goal to tie it 1-1. Rangers line back together.
Yeah, Lafreniere back out there with Kreider and Zibanejad. Sometimes there's a little, maybe an equipment issue or something, and you have to do some juggling. But so that so Lafreniere right back out there. Missed one shift with that other twosome.
We talked about Jason Spezza, who wins the faceoff there. This is game number 1181 in his career. Former number two pick overall in 2001. Long shot by Hall, wide. Kreider gets it to Zibanejad, and out it goes. That went by Simmons, played the other way by Miller to Kreider. And now back to Keandre Miller. Trouba. On the boards it goes. Kreider there to play it. Battles with Justin Hall. Lafreniere swings it around the boards. Fox after it against Jake Muzzin. Spezza pokes at it. And it's cleared out. Lindgren recovers. Hall tried to clear. Kreider's pass goes by Panarin, who just came off the bench. Engvall for Toronto. A bouncer steered away by Shesterkin. Fox for Zibanejad. Pass for Panarin. He's tied up by T.J. Brody. Goodrow after it, but Riley has the puck and reverses to Brody. A little over 8 minutes gone by here in the second period. The game tied 1-1. Alex Kerfoot. Round the net, wraparound went off of Shesterkin. Down comes Riley, back past the camp. Kerfoot behind the net, checked by Lundqvist. Now Kerfoot leaves it there for Kasha, back to Kerfoot. And Lundqvist checks him and stays with him. Good job, deflected the pass off the side of the net. Riley in deep, ridden down by Goodrow. Goodrow's been physical. This is a big part of his game.
Now that's like what Toronto likes to do. They love to get those defense involved in the offensive zone.
That's off the side of the net. Chance for Travis Dermott. Save, another save. Two great saves. First on Dermott, then on Richie. And Shesterkin outstanding. That's blocked by McKeag on the shot by Travis Dermott. Good pressure by Toronto. Rangers having trouble getting out of the zone. They do. Ryan Reeves moves in. And the puck taken away by Mitch Marner. Up ahead, Nick Ritchie. Keandre Miller got over with good speed, but gave it away to Matthews, who gave it away to Reeves. McKeag moves in. Dermott is back. In the middle, Hunt was hit by Ritchie. And the Leafs take over. Lead to Mitch Marner. Marner crisscrosses, looks, back pass, and the shot by Tavares, a save by Shesterkin. And the whistle stops play.
Got to be on Toronto. They had control of the puck. Too many men on the ice.
It's on the Leafs as they put the pressure on. Shesterkin made at least three grade A saves.
Yeah. Now the game suddenly opened up, Sam. I mean, it was back and forth, both teams. And so Toronto with a change, and that the man coming off the bench way too early. And so this was going on. There's one chance. Here's a shot. Beautiful save there. Stops another one there. Marner was there. He couldn't get it as Panarin was able to get to the puck first. And so the Rangers in this 1-1 game, Rangers have it. Trouble getting shots, just one shot in this period thus far, but they'll get an opportunity here on the power play.
Too many men on the ice at 9:54. Gives the Rangers their second power play. This power play brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers.
Oh, another face-off winner. The Rangers, they can't win a face-off.
Wow.
I mean, they just can't win a face-off.
Now the Rangers head up ice. Fox, Panarin, Kreider, Zibanejad, and Lafreniere. Zibanejad off the boards. Riley takes over. And out it goes. Adam Fox. Now Chris Kreider. That went off the skate on goal. Campbell, one hands it around to Brody, who fires it out. Fox recovers. Lead for Lafreniere. That went off the glass and deflected up into the netting, out of play.
As that faceoff will, I believe, come outside the zone. Toronto's won 18 of the 25 faceoffs in this game, and especially, you know, you're on the power play, you want to get control in the offensive zone. Toronto's winning them and clearing it. That takes a lot of time off the clock.
That's 72%, Joe.
Yep.
Wow. Heedle on with Sammy Blais, Dryden Hunt.
Good Neil job
Flunquist
there.
Flunquist and Jacob Trouba.
Heedle won that one.
But the takeaway by Hall and the clear. Minute 10 to go in the Rangers power play. The game tied 1-1, 9-10 to go, second period. Jacob Trouba, Philip Heedle. Now Dryden Hunt. Hunt against Hall. Trouba. Heedle. Checked there by Engvall. Off the boards to Sammy Blais. Good pressure by the Leafs, and they take it away. Alex Kerfoot with it. Kerfoot moves in. Made the move behind the back, and Trouba stayed with him. Blais. Pass off the skate of Nylander. Played in deep by Lundqvist. Trouba's tied up by David Kampf, number 64. TJ Brody back for it. And Riley fires it all the way down. 15 seconds to go on the Rangers power play. And no power in this one. Rangers have been unable to get anything going on each of their two power plays. Lafreniere moves in. Power play is over. Pass to Zibanejad, went behind the back with it. Here's Fox shooting. That's blocked in front. Kreider went between the legs with a shot that was blocked. And the Leafs clear, and it's an icing on Toronto. 7:52 to go here in the second. Game tied 1-1.
Yeah, the Rangers had trouble with the pressure that Toronto was putting on in their own zone. I mean, they just kept after the puck, after the puck, after the puck, and the Rangers never had a chance to get control and set anything up.
Rangers have only one shot on goal through 12 minutes here in the second period. Kreider taking the face off. Muzzin moves it, and it's brought out by Austin Matthews. John Tavares on with Matthews and Marner. That's a power line. Oh, nice play by Fox on the takeaway. Lafreniere trying to get it to Kreider. There's Lafreniere across, offside whistle. 7:31 to go, second period. Rangers and Leafs tied 1-1.
Credited with 18 hits in the game thus far. And for Ryan Reeves, he has four of those. And he hasn't passed up an opportunity, nor has Sammy Blais. Sammy Blais credited with three, but seems like he's got more than that. There's another one. There's three right there. There's four. So we've already counted four. And Ryan Reeves been involved. Good role. As Sam, you mentioned earlier that he hasn't passed up an opportunity to hit anyone. So they just got to find a way to get that forecheck going again and put some offensive zone pressure on.
Rangers have not had a shot on goal over the last 9 minutes, 20 seconds. McDermott moves it. Good pressure by the Rangers. Back forward to Spezza. Long pass out, intercepted by Nemeth. Sandin, number 38, moves it around the boards for Engvall. Out for Wayne Simmonds. Nemeth is back. This is Travis Dermott. Pass hit. Wayne Simmonds didn't get a shot off. Engvall missed wide. Comes around to Simmonds. That's blocked by Nemeth. Now Blais around the board to hit Rooney. Comes back to Blais. Backhands it around for Gauthier. That's blocked by Sandin.
Again, those defense, they try to stay in at every opportunity. They just pinch the boards. The middle is open if you have enough time to look up and make a play up the middle of the ice.
Out to the red line for Reeves. Reeves battling Muzzin. Puck picked up by McKeag. Save made. Oh, good play by Greg McKeag, and the Rangers break that schneid of no shots in almost 10 minutes of play. Thursday night, the Rangers, after a couple of days off, take on the Nashville Predators in Nashville. Live coverage begins at 7:30 on MSG with Rangers Game Night with John Giannone and Steve Alliquette. The puck drops at 8 p.m. Thursday on MSG, or stream it on MSG Go. Nice to have Mr. Lundquist in attendance.
Good to see Henrik tonight. Again.
Always good to get his view of things. Shot by Reeves, save! Rebound chance. Dryden Hunt couldn't get a stick on it. Now McKeg.
This all started with McKeg winning a faceoff cleanly back to his defenseman, and the Rangers have kept the pressure on since.
Camp for the outlet. Brought in by Kerfoot. His shot saved. Shesterkin, the rebound to Andre Kasha. Now Alex Kerfoot. He's checked there by Miller. Riley lifting it ahead for Kasha. Tavares' pass was blocked and chipped out of the zone. Good play by Philip Hedl. 5:35 to go in the second period. Tied 1-1. William Nylander. Nice stick handling. And the shot deflected. Great stick work by Miller, recovering as Nylander was going by him. 5:27 to go. Second period in Toronto. Tied 1-1.
Damn, you know, we mentioned the best player for the Toronto Maple Leafs thus far has been this guy, William Nylander. How about this move? Shifty, gets around Hedl, and then a good job by Miller getting a piece of that shot.
Tavares and Goodrow for the faceoff. Leafs have it. Justin Hall moves it deep. Off the back of the net, Goodrow gets to it. Nice play by Goodrow to get it to Fox, but Fox's pass blocked by Nylander. Fox around the board, stopped by Muzzin. And deep, Nylander. His pass blocked by Fox. Nylander tries again. Shot stopped by Shesterkin. Didn't know where the rebound was. Zibanejad was able to play it, but it's kept in by Muzzin. Muzzin's pass broken up by Lindgren. Kreider passed through to Zibanejad. And it's taken back by the Leafs, Michael Bunting. Bunting has the goal for Toronto. Zibanejad has scored for the Rangers. Nylander takes a hit and goes down. Nemeth with the hit. P.J. Brody shoots just wide. It's Marner with the puck. Toronto putting on some pressure here. Marner's pass taken away by Fox. And he lifts it out of the zone. 4:20 to go, second period. Tied 1-1. Austin Matthews pass right through the crease and by Mitch Marner. Here's Matthews again. Saves Shesterkin. He got the rebound as well as he stopped Morgan Riley. Oh, Shesterkin outstanding.
He's the reason why this game is still 1-1.
Right.
25 shots now total for Toronto to just 12 for the Rangers.
Leafs with 13 shots. To two here in the second, and that went off the helmet of Shesterkin. The shot by Matthews. He did the Henrik Lundqvist header. Matthews. Now Jason Spezza. Back pass just off the bench. Dermott, a little late getting on, missed the pass, and it went all the way back. 3.5 minutes to go in the second. Jason Spezza moves in. Spezza's shot blocked. Shot by Simmons was stopped by Shesterkin. And a penalty upcoming on the Rangers. A late penalty call. Rangers touch up. And a hooking call on Julien Gauthier will give Toronto their third power play.
Boy, the constant pressure in the offensive zone leads to penalties. There's the shot by Matthews. One save, and then Morgan Riley, the defenseman, so aggressive for Toronto. He moved in and got the rebound, and one more. That one goes off the helmet or the face mask of Lundqvist. And just all kinds of offensive zone pressure leads to the penalty. And the Rangers are trying to hang on in this period with 3:18 to go. And now another Maple Leaf power play.
Shesterkin is getting a lot of work.
Sure is.
Wow. Power play, faceoff win Tavares. Riley moves it. Gauthier for hooking. At 16:42, glove save Shesterkin on the shot by Riley. And the Leafs now with 27 shots on goal.
Yeah, that was it. That was a shot that Shesterkin was able to see all the way. No one in front of the net. As here comes the shot, and you can see Tavares was there, then moved out. I don't think Tavares thought that Riley would take the shot, and so it turned out to be an easy save.
Barkley Goodrow in to take the face off. Goodrow and Zibanejad, Trouba and Lindgren for the Rangers penalty kill. Austin Matthews holding. Morgan Riley, Matthews, Marner shot, saves Shesterkin, and no rebound.
Again, a clean faceoff win. Toronto gets control of the puck. And that time, Matthews, instead of taking the shot from that side, just dishes it to the middle. And Marner gets the shot right off the pass.
Just under 3 minutes to go here in the second period. And the Leafs have outshot the Rangers 16-2 here in the period. It's a 1-1 game. Riley off another faceoff win by Toronto. Here's Matthews. Now Marner. McKegg is there. Nylander. Played by Riley. William Nylander. Out to Matthews. Rooney is on with McKegg. Riley shoots, save Shesterkin, and again, no rebound. He is controlling play. Excellent goaltending by Igor Shesterkin.
Now, right off the faceoff, let's see what happens here. McKegg goes down, tries to play it with his hand. I think Toronto thought there should have been a penalty. I'm not sure it ever touched his glove. Looked like Tavares got it with the stick, and there's just another save, number 28.
Another Toronto faceoff win. They have dominated.
Sam, they're winning everything cleanly. I mean, it's not even close.
Here's a chance. Oh, Fox tried to hit Goodrow in neutral zone.
Just missed.
Just missed connecting. Just under a minute to go in the Toronto power play. 2:10 to go in the second period. Game tied 1-1. Mitch Marner. Now John Tavares. Riley. Goodrow and Zibanejad. Fox. And Nemeth on to the Rangers. Tavares drops it to Marner. Out to Riley. Back to William Nylander. Side of the net, Tavares. Outside Riley. Marner got knocked down. Pass intercepted. Fox clears it out to Zibanejad. He's joined by Goodrow. Zibanejad fakes. Hits the side of the net.
Boy, and room. Steve Ellicott talked about that in the pregame show, that there would be room that the goaltender Jack Campbell goes down and leaves the corner on the short side open. And Zibanejad faked and had room, but hit the side of the net.
Spezza moves in. Spezza looks, holds, fires wide. And the Rangers have killed it off. Gauthier out of the penalty box, has the puck, leaves it to Kreider. Tried to hit Hedl, but off his stick. And say a big thank you to Igor Shesterkin for his goaltending on that Toronto power play. He was absolutely brilliant. Under a minute to go, second period. The game tied 1-1. The Leafs are 0-for-3 on the power play with 8 shots. Andre Kasha moves in against Fox. Fox stayed with him. Panarin helps out. Fox with a takeaway. Panarin has to flex out. Rangers have had only 2 shots on goal here in the second period. The Leafs have had 17 and have scored once. Panarin's got it. 20 seconds to go in the period. Panarin tries to beat Hall. Hall stays with him, moves the puck to Travis Dermott. Up ahead, Kerfoot. Now David Camp. Andre Kasha sends it in. 5 seconds to go in the period. Sammy Blais takes a hit, and the period comes to an end. And Igor Shesterkin was absolutely brilliant in that second period, as he stopped 16 of 17 shots to keep the Rangers in the game.
Yeah, that's the reason the game is tied 1-1, so the Rangers can go into the locker room, take a deep breath, and say, come on, let's get our game going again. Our goaltender just saved us.
Coming up, It's the second intermission report. And John Giannone and Henrik Lundqvist and Steve Valiquette will be in the studio with highlights and analysis. Bill Pito's got the Audi MSG 150 all coming up on the second period intermission report. A period dominated by the Toronto Maple Leafs. They scored one goal early by Michael Bunting. That tied the game. And then Igor Shesterkin did a great job. Now, what happened here?
Yeah, Simmons bumped into Shesterkin, and then that brought Reeves to the middle of the ice. And it took them a while to leave the ice surface.
All right. The Leafs and the Rangers beating up for the first time in a long time. Rangers scoring in the first period. Mika Zibanejad, Michael Bunting in the second. And then it was all Igor Shesterkin. In Toronto, getting set for a big third period. Game tied 1-1. New York Rangers hockey on MSG Networks is presented by Chase. Now, let's answer the Cadillac trivia question. Which Rangers legend scored a goal in his NHL debut on today's date in 1952? You got it, Joe.
I don't think I have it. I think you have it.
Number three, Harry Howell.
Harry Howell.
Yeah, there it is at Toronto. Harry, we miss you.
Boy, oh boy.
God bless.
What a man.
The legendary Harry Howell.
What a guy.
Great New York Ranger. Now, I'm sure Gerard Gallant wasn't happy with that second period.
He didn't. You know what? And he probably didn't have to say much to the players, Sam, because they couldn't have been happy either. They didn't have the puck much. You know, Henrik made an excellent point. You try to open up against this Toronto team. That's the way they love to play. They've got so many offensive weapons that you're probably not going to win that battle unless your goaltender does what he did in that period.
Underway third period. The Leafs have had over 50 shot attempts to 22 for the Rangers in the game.
Jack Campbell, the Toronto goaltender, has not been tested much in this game.
No.
And they got to find a way to test him. But you know that man right there, Sam, he's been tested.
Wow.
You know, he was solid in the first period and he was just fabulous in the second period. I mean, he just had to stop a lot of these and first shot, second opportunity. As Steve Valiquette jokingly said, and we think it was a joke, that might have been the best performance in a period by any New York Ranger goaltender ever. Did you hear him say that, Sam?
He said that with Henrik Lundqvist.
I think he was kidding. I think he was kidding, but I don't know. You know Steve, right? I'm not sure he was kidding. Of course he was.
Stir it up, Steve.
It's good that they're having some fun.
Yeah. Opening minute, second period. Third period, excuse me. The Rangers continue to be a good shot blocking team. They've had 12 blocked shots. They had a big night in Montreal with 18 blocked shots.
Yeah, you can really see, you know, the two players that are on the lineup, their top six, are so missed because they both with Strome and Kako, they get in quick. They get in on the forecheck. They make plays. That's a big hole in this lineup with those two out. And yet here they are, and I'm sure they got reminded. Play one good period, and you come out of Toronto with points.
David Kaft moving in. DeAndre Miller was there, and Philip Hedl took it away.
Or play another lousy period, and if your goaltender plays like that, you come out of Toronto with points. They got a couple options.
Deflected on goal, and just circling there to stop it. I think they like the first option better.
The first option would be better. But it's nice to have more than one.
That deflects off the stick of Julian Gauthier and up into the stands it goes. A minute 23 into this third period.
You know, Sam, we showed at the end of that second period there was a little kind of skirmish going on between these two teams after the final buzzer went, but I'm sure both teams got to be a little careful here in this 1-1 game. They don't want to put their team down.
Talked about the faceoffs. John Giannone gave you the numbers through two periods. John Tavares has won 14 of 16.
Now, he came into this game, Sam, having won over 66% in the first three games.
Rangers able to clear it out. They play back Sandin, number 38, to Travis Dermott, number 23. Dermott. Tavares' pass got through. And a save made. Sandin had the chance, and there's Shesterkin with another save.
Yeah, and there you see the Toronto defense, again, very aggressive getting up in the play. And Sandin, and it starts from behind their own net, and Sandin's the defenseman, and look where he is, breaking up the other side. They find him. He tries to use the Rangers defenseman Nemeth as a screen, which he did, but Shesterkin in good position to stop that.
Zibanejad on for the faceoff with Kreider and Panarin here. Faceoff, Leafs control again. Mitch Marner. Lindgren gets it to Panarin. His pass intercepted. Matthews shoots, save made by Shesterkin. Ooh, that cross-ice pass. And Matthews was there to intercept and had a big scoring chance. Zibanejad and Kreider. Zibanejad checked by Brody.
We saw Gerard Gallant make a lot of line changes in that second period. Many different combinations.
There's Panarin lifting it out of the zone. Wayne Simmons sends it back in. Lindgren looks around. Pressured by Jason Spezza. Adam Fox gets it to Panarin. Long shift for Panarin. Reeves has come on.
Now Reeves and
McKay.
Keep an eye on these two lines that are out there now. Reeves is on the ice, and he was having words with Simmons, who's on the ice also. And there they are. They come together there.
Engvall moves in. Rangers break it up. DeAndre Miller gets to it and controls it. 3:20 gone by here in the third. Greg McKay. And the Leafs take it right back.
Puck's got to go in deep. The Rangers have to try and get some forecheck going. There's not a play at the blue line. You've got to get it in deep, and they're too good of a counterattack team.
Heedle shoots wide. Goodrow made a good play in the defensive zone. Breaking up a Toronto play. Brody back for it. Beadle on the forecheck. Goodrow with a hit. Took the puck away. Gets it to Lafreniere. Here's Nemeth with a shot wide. So the line here is Beadle, Lafreniere, and Goodrow. Leafs able to come out with it. David Camp. Bumped by Lafreniere. In after it is Alex Kerfoot. Around it goes to Nylander. Hall winds up. Big shot. Missed the net wide. That's fired wide by Muzzin. Brought in by Bunting. He shoots. Save Shesterkin. Boy, Bunting is playing with a lot of jump and a lot of confidence. He has the Leafs goal. Tavares. Checked by Heedle. And the wraparound try on the backhand stopped by Shesterkin, and he covers up. 4:42 gone by here in the third.
Yeah, Bunting plays a high energy game, and he has shown that. There's the turnover that led to that chance. And then Tavares tries to wrap around, and there you saw Shesterkin just waiting for him, and then is able to cover up.
And the third period starts the same way as the second. Leafs with five shots, Rangers only one.
Faceoff control by the Rangers this time. Kevin Rooney
Sam, they're
is
just,
on for that.
They're just using their other option.
Yeah, right. Shesterkin, that shot missed by Tavares, and he looked up to the rafters, wondering how he missed. Sandin to Tavares. Man in front, and the shot save made. Bunting with the shot, the turnaround backhander, and Shesterkin made another outstanding save.
Oh, he just doesn't give up.
Ooh, Sandin got away with one in the neutral zone. He pulled down one of the Rangers, may have been Gauthier, but nothing was called. Leafs are offside here.
Now Bunting just worked, and then this is just prior to that, though. Here's the shot by John Tavares, and you know what? Hit the shaft of the stick.
Mm.
And then one more. Here's Bunting here, 58, where he just spins around, and Shesterkin stops that with the left leg.
And that's seven shots on goal here in this third period for the Leafs. In the first 5 minutes, 18 seconds.
A little rope-a-dope never hurts anybody, Sam.
So Gerard Gallant staying with this unit of Zibanejad, Kreider, and Panarin. As he looks to get Panarin going. Justin Hall and Muzzin pressured by Kreider. Forced a turnover. Here's Panarin, and that was blocked away. Played by Richie. Rangers came close as they forced the turnover by Jake Muzzin. Rangers come in again. Panarin leads Zibanejad. Zibanejad in deep. A back pass to Trouba. That's deflected wide. Panarin with Justin Hall on him. Matthews pushed it ahead. Taken back by Keandre Miller. This is a good shift for the Rangers. They picked it up a little bit and got something going in the offensive zone. A little over 6 minutes gone by. 6:15 gone by in the third. Riley dumps it in and chases. Nemeth is back there. Round to Engvall. That pass all the way through. Out comes Dryden Hunt. Hunt against Spezza. Jason Spezza takes it back. Around for Engvall. Ryan Reeves is there, battling for the puck. Leafs able to clear it out, and it's chipped ahead. Hunt is back for it for the Rangers. Tipped ahead by McKay. Campbell leaves it behind the net for T.J. Brody. Game tied 1-1, nearly 7 minutes gone by here in the third period. Shesterkin looks around. Plays it off the glass. Stopped by Kerfoot. That was blocked, and the Rangers break out. Goodrow with Lafreniere. Now Hedl comes in. Goodrow in the corner. Sandin is there for Toronto, along with David Camp. Goodrow battling. Keeps it alive. And the Leafs come out with it. Dermott able to move it to Kerfoot. That pass too far for Camp. It's an icing on the Leafs. 7:33 gone by here in the third period of a 1-1 game.
Yeah, there's the young Sandin. As you mentioned, Sam, went right after the next pick. That's Hall, not
Justin Hall. He's
Sandin.
Just back in the lineup.
Right, he was six and missed the game. And then that was Hall that did a good job blocking that shot by Panarin.
Yeah, Hall and Sundin were on as a defensive pair. Jacob Trouba, now Mika Zibanejad with Panarin. Leafs break it up, the alley-oop for Nylander. He drives to the net and he shoots wide. With Keandre Miller all over him and no penalty on the play.
Yeah, Miller came back and lifted his stick just as he was going to shoot.
Here's Nylander still with it. Pass in front for Tavares. He was checked from behind by Panarin. Panarin controlling. And it was pressured into a turnover by Bunting. But the Rangers able to take it back and clear. Trouba off the boards for Kevin Rooney. Rooney for Gauthier. In front, save by Campbell. Rangers' best chance, Sammy Blais. Best chance in long time. Lindgren blocked in front. Rangers find it. Fox off the boards to Blay. Back to Fox. Now Ryan Lindgren with a wrist shot, and it's gloved by Campbell, and he holds it. Rangers get something going in the offensive zone. Campbell comes up with a save. Keandre Miller, a big defensive play on William Nylander. 11:13 to go, third period, tied 1-1.
Well, the Rangers finally tested the goaltender, Jack Campbell, and it was Sammy Blay that had the chance, and Campbell came up with a brilliant save. Here's the feed from Gauthier to the other side. One more look. Gauthier does a nice job kicking the puck up to his stick and finding Sammy Blay, who let it go right away, and beautiful save by Campbell.
Rooney, Blay, and Gauthier on for the Rangers. Mika Zibanejad scored for the Rangers in the first period. Michael Bunting for the Leafs in the second. And that's it. Here's Austin Matthews. Matthews with five shots on goal in the game, six shots on goal in the game. 11 shot attempts in his first game of the season. Gauthier trying to clear. Muzzin stepped up. Rangers got it out of the zone. And it turns into an icing. 10:35 to go here in the third period.
Yeah, that's the pressure again by the Toronto Maple Leafs. Now Fox out of the corner. Watch. I mean, not many players make this pass. Fox eludes one man and then just throws it right to the middle and right onto the stick of a teammate. But the Rangers end up getting called for icing as Gauthier tried to get it out of the zone at the blue line, put it all the way down the ice.
Nice play by Gauthier to tip it out of the zone. The back pass from Nylander was intended for Riley. Leafs move in again. Nylander off the boards to Tavares. Truba is there. Now Adam Fox lifts it out. Reeves after it. Reeves against TJ Brody. Greg McKegg is on. Dryden Hunt is on. Miller steps up. That deflects up into the netting. 10:07 to go here in the third period.
I think Ryan Reeves has been the most effective forechecker the Rangers have had in this game. Every time he's on the ice, they get it in deep. Boy, he's one of the first guys in, gets a hit. Did a good job there getting a hit and then taking control of the puck and kicking it back to Miller, who took the shot, but his shot got deflected up into the netting.
McKegg and Spezza on the faceoff. Spezza wins it into the corner. Leafs move it up the boards. Truba tried to play it. It was cleared out all the way down. Miller takes a hit from Wayne Simmonds. Riley steps up. Truba got knocked down by Simmonds. Truba able to clear the zone. 9:40 to go, third period, tied 1-1. Spezza and Engvall. Spezza and Miller go after it. Miller moves it around the boards. Panarin brings it out. Semi Panarin, Rangers changing lines. Kreider has come on. Zibanejad just came on with a steal by Engvall. Kampf gave it up to Nils Lundqvist. Kampf took it back. Deep in the Rangers zone. Nemeth moves it around. Hart around the boards. Panarin looks for a man. Finds Kreider. Kreider shoots and it's blocked by Muzzin. Taken back by Panarin. Here's Zibanejad for Kreider. Oh, great play by Campbell with a stick. Kreider was open at the side of the net and Campbell got the stick on the pass. It goes out of play with 8:55 to go in the third period. Rangers and Leafs tied 1-1.
He has goals in his first three games and he almost scored again in this one. Here's a look at the first three, all deflections. That's Washington up the side of the net, or from the side of the net, I should say. The Dallas Stars, he beautiful redirection there. Montreal, he gets another deflection for a goal. And then just moments ago, takes his pass from Zibanejad, or it was close, but Jack Campbell does a good job with his stick and deflects the puck away.
Leafs break out off the faceoff. Mitch Marner gains the zone, try to hit Nylander, but that was broken up by Ryan Lindgren. Here's Austin Matthews. That's stopped by Adam Fox. Kreider one hands it in deep. Justin Hall taken back by Zibanejad. Behind the net, Hall. Lindgren pinching in, but Matthews cleared the zone. Zibanejad has it back. Adam Fox. Good pass to Kreider. Tries to get it to Zibanejad.
Kreider drew a penalty. Coming. Kreider drew a penalty.
Rangers get a power play with 8:14 to go here in the third.
Sam, just as you said, beautiful pass from Fox, which it was. He put it on the stick of Kreider, and then Kreider took two strides, got hooked on the play, and so the Rangers will get a power play with 8:14 to go. There it is again. Fox made a defensive play first in the defensive zone on Austin Matthews. And then makes that little pass to Kreider, who then drew the penalty.
Muzzin for hooking at 11:46.
I think the Rangers have taken a timeout. That was their, you know, some of their top players. Zibanejad was on the ice. Fox was on the ice. Kreider was on. That's their power play. Mm. So I think they're giving them a rest so that they can start this power play rested.
Stay with us right after the game. We've got complete post-game coverage, and you don't want to miss it because that's great hockey analysis. John Giannone, Steve Valiquette, and Henrik Lundqvist. So stay tuned for their complete analysis of the game, highlights, analysis, and interviews. All coming up on Mercedes-Benz Rangers postgame.
That was a good timeout to take. I mean, the game might come down to this right here, this power play. The way Shesterkin has been playing, if they can just find a way to get something here, and there's another faceoff win by Toronto, which
all night long.
We've talked about it all night.
Leafs have won over 70% of the faceoffs in the game. Fox, Zibanejad, Kreider, Panarin, and Lafreniere for the power play, which is 0-for-2 in the game. Zibanejad around the boards for Kreider. It's by him. He went down, and the Leafs batted out of the zone. Rangers take it back. Zibanejad moves in. Panarin's pass blocked. Played on goal by Zibanejad. I think he wanted a pass to Lafreniere, wound up sliding on goal.
Now, the penalty killing for Toronto has been excellent. I mean, they just the pressure that they put on the Rangers all over the ice. There's pressure here at the blue line. And then that's the last kind of a reach by Zibanejad to keep the play alive. Just gets a piece of it, but Campbell holds on.
Second unit on. Leafs win another faceoff, and they clear all the way down.
And these are clean faceoff wins.
Third period faceoffs. Leafs have won 7 of 7. But the Rangers still on the power play, a little over a minute to go. Lundqvist tips it into the Leafs zone. Campbell try to play it. Rangers have Sammy Blais, Dryden Hunt, Philip Hedl, Jacob Trouba, and Nils Lundqvist. The puck went out of play. Faceoff stays in the Leafs zone with 57 seconds to go on the power play. And the first power play unit returns to the ice.
Yeah, you win those faceoffs that cleanly. And the Toronto player says much he's got all kinds of time to just pick a spot to get the puck down the ice. And then it just takes a good 15 seconds off the clock or so.
Spezza and Kreider. And the Rangers control. Fox to Panarin. Panarin looks. That was a pass for Lafreniere. It was just missed. A redirection up high. Fox recovers. Lafreniere. Panarin off the boards for Kreider. Around it goes. David Kampf is there. Give it up to Kreider behind the net. Up to Panarin. To Kreider. Back up the boards. Panarin. To Fox. Across to Zibanejad. That was blocked by Justin Hall. 18 seconds to go on the Rangers power play. Fox moves in. Panarin. Across it goes to Kreider. Looks. Plays it around the boards to Panarin. Fox. Back to Panarin. Now Zibanejad to Fox. Zibanejad shot blocked. Oh, what a block by Morgan Riley. Power play is over. That shot deflects up into the netting. Off the stick of Kreider, and the power play is over. 6:09 to go. And the Rangers had only one shot on goal on that power play.
And a standing ovation for Riley as he blocked it. They finally are able to set up Zibanejad for that vaunted one-timer of his, and Morgan Riley gets in the way and then gets back up and deflects one more up into the netting. That's why he got the standing ovation.
And one thing about the Rangers in the last several minutes, the Leafs have had no shots on goal. Rangers have had four in the third period, Toronto seven. No scoring here in the third. 1-1 game with 6 minutes to go in the third. Muzzin off the boards to Nylander. Keandre Miller takes over. Austin Matthews on him. Chip clear. Heedle, Goodrow, and Gauthier on for the Rangers. Matthews to Tavares. Oh. Tavares back for Matthews. By him, Keandre Miller one-hands it to Goodrow. He was tied up by Matthews. Miller to Trouba. Gauthier couldn't clear, his block by Muzzin. That's knocked down by Miller. And a heads-up play by Miller, and it got help from Goodrow, who cleared it. Jake Muzzin. Pass all the way across. He's down by Spezza to Simmons. Save, Shesterkin. Out to Rasmus Sandin. Behind the net, Jason Spezza against Fox. Spezza on the ice, tried a shot that went wide. Lindgren battling Simmons. Fox lifts it on the backhand. Down the ice it goes. No icing. Played by Travis Dermott. Intercepted by Kevin Rooney. Brighton Hunt wins the battle behind the net. Good play. Up the boards to Trouba. And across to Nemeth for a shot. Saved by Campbell. Kerfoot swings it around. Engvall playing it back to Sandin. 4:25 to go in the third. Alex Kerfoot lifts it in. Patrick Nemeth back for it. Moves it quickly to Trouba. Out of the zone, Panarin fires across. Nemeth has it. Campbell goes to get it. Backhands it into the corner to Brody. Up ahead, Andre Kasha. Nice takeaway by Panarin. In comes Kreider. Looks, finds Panarin. Now Zibanejad. Whoa! Man, Campbell looked behind him. And the Leafs come out. That was a big chance for Mika Zibanejad.
Well, it all started with that takeaway by Panarin. Yeah. Picked a pocket in the, you know, the Toronto player in the neutral zone, and away they went. And three or four passes later, Zibanejad had a chance for his second goal of the game. Kreider with one pass, and then Zibanejad with that, and it hit Riley's stick. I'm not sure it ever got to Jack Campbell or not, but what a chance for Zibanejad. Beautiful passing.
Icing was whistled on the Rangers. 3:34 to go. And Heedle playing it back into the corner. Here's Mitch Marner. Richie sets up in front. Austin Matthews against Philip Heedle. Nick Richie checked by Fox. Marner, the back pass to Hall and across to Muzzin. Turning for a quick shot, Richie was blocked by Adam Fox and lifted out. Hall is there to play it. Good pressure by Heedle. Muzzin around the Hall. 3 minutes to go. Third period, tied 1-1. That went off of Lafreniere's stick. Shesterkin plays it. Pass Lafreniere. Leafs have it back. Morgan Riley, now William Nylander. Tavares. Taken away by Trouba. Sammy Blais sends it back to Keandre Miller. Now Trouba. fires it ahead. Goodrow after it against T.J. Brody. In comes Greg McKay. Goodrow trying to move it. He's tied up there. Rangers control. Shot by Miller. High off the glass. Rangers keep it in. McKay. And it's given away to Goodrow. Leaves it for Miller. Shot wide. Brody on the backhand. Clears it out. And no icing. Played by Trouba. 2 minutes to go in regulation time. Tied 1-1. Rangers scored in the first period, a goal by Mika Zibanejad. The Leafs tied it in the second, a goal by Michael Bunting. And that's it. Zibanejad left it for Kreider, forces his way in, fires, and a save by Campbell. And a takeaway by Panarin. The pass knocked down and brought out by Andrei Kasha. Kasha against Lindgren, saves Shesterkin. Kasha taken down by Lindgren. Kreider able to move it to Zibanejad, a minute 20 to go. That pass tipped, taken by Panarin, now gets help from Fox. Patrick Nemeth just came on, a minute 10 to go. Fox holding. Kevin Rooney dumping it in. Under a minute to go, Ryan Reeves. Out to Nemeth. Nemeth with a shot to flex it in the corner. Rooney to Trouba. Back to Rooney. Rooney against Austin Matthews. Winds it around. Gets it back. Rooney finds Trouba. A deflection. A save made by Campbell. And it's out of the zone. 35 seconds to go in regulation time. Rooney. Leafs move up. Morgan Rielly, wide of the net, off the end boards. Lindgren, taken away by Marner, gets it to Matthews. His shot deflected wide. Rebound to Nick Ritchie. Pass for Matthews. He was checked by Lafreniere. Final seconds of regulation time. And for the second time this season, the Rangers are going to overtime. Wow. 1-1 with the Toronto Maple Leafs. No scoring in the third. Austin Matthews had a chance. Campbell has been good. Overtime is coming up next. This is our Ford goal replay, and it leads to how we got here, Joe.
Well, it starts with that man, Mika Zibanejad, who scored his first goal of the season. Maple Leafs turn it over. Zibanejad coming off the bench. Fires that one in. That gave the Rangers a 1-0 lead. And then Morgan Rielly let it rush. He'll throw it in front. Michael Bunting, who's a big story here in Toronto, goes hard to the net, gets a piece of it, and then it goes off Shesterkin and in. And that tied it at 1 for Bunting, his second goal of the season. And that man right there is the reason we're going to overtime.
37 saves. What an effort by Igor Shesterkin. And the second period, absolutely brilliant. Toronto Maple Leafs, to their credit, Joe, have not given up a third period goal in four games this season.
Hey, listen, I've been impressed with the way they played defensively. Yeah. They haven't given the Rangers much at all in this game.
And especially on the penalty kill, right. They've shut the Rangers' power play down.
They've been aggressive all over the ice. Their defense are really pushed to play in the offensive zone. And then when you mentioned the penalty killing, Sam, just pressure all over the ice. Everybody going and in tandem, in rhythm, and they've kept the Rangers power play off balance.
Through regulation, 38-19, as the Leafs double up the Rangers in shots for three periods. Here we go, 3-on-3, sudden death overtime. Rangers have Zibanejad, Kreider, and Fox. The Leafs have Matthews, Marner, and Rielly. This is Austin Matthews. Rangers overtime game against Dallas. They were beaten by the Stars in the second minute of the overtime. Here's Rielly. Matthews goes to the front. Rielly finds Matthews. Checked there by Fox. Those two may find themselves on the U.S. Olympic team. Mitch Marner. Kreider is there. Now Matthews leaves it for Marner. He plays it back to the goaltender as Marner wants to change.
Yep.
Brody leads Matthews. Rangers were changing. Matthews shoots wide. Trouba got over. Kreider outlets to Trouba. Lafreniere is on. Lead for Lafreniere. Back in front for Kreider to Trouba. Save Campbell. Oh, Rangers came close. Here's Nylander. Panarin is there. Nylander. Save by Shesterkin. Here's a chance. Wide by Muzzin. Oh, man. Panarin the other way. Muzzin is there. Panarin shake and bake. Still with it. Lafreniere. DeAndre Miller is on with them. The Go Leafs go chant up. Miller driving toward the net. Forced behind the net. Now Panarin finds Lafreniere. Kerfoot on him. And that's sent all the way back to the goaltender so the Rangers can change. Fox comes back on. Goodrow is on. Fox carries in. Sammy Blais has come on. Fox looks. Checked there by Riley. Blais around the Goodrow. John Tavares on for Toronto. Here's Fox. 2:15 gone by in the overtime. Adam Fox moves in with Blais and Goodrow. Pass blocked by Riley. Fox takes it back out.
Just missed. He had Goodrow streaking down the left side, did Fox.
Sammy Blais carries in, drives to the net, and a save by Campbell. Kerfoot has it. Kerfoot leads Marner. Marner moves in, Blais is there. Heedle has just come on. Matthews to the net, save Shesterkin. Wraparound to save Shesterkin. Blais pass gets through to Fox. Long shift for Fox. Heedle moves up. Blais goes to the bench. Fox goes to the bench. 2 minutes remaining in overtime. Heedle. Now Kevin Rooney. Rooney trying to find Trouba. Trouba got in front of Matthews. After it was Brody. Shesterkin off the board. Stopped by Matthews. Save Shesterkin. Here comes Nylander. Now Matthews. Save. And the rebound went wide. Oh, is this wild? Shesterkin made a save 20 feet out of the crease. Rooney is across the line. A minute and a half to go in overtime. Man, is this exciting. Here's a lead. Zibanejad with Miller 2-on-1. Save with a glove. Oh, what a save by Campbell. You believe these goals?
Oh, we went for a minute without anybody getting a shot or hardly attempting a shot. And then we had these goaltenders come up with a number of saves, especially Shesterkin. He couldn't clear it, has to make that save. Keep an eye on him. He's not finished yet. There's another one on Matthews. Matthews then thought he had the open net, but Trouba defended that. Oh, man, what a sequence of events. And then right at the end, Campbell was on his way down. Zibanejad tried to beat him high, and Campbell with the glove.
Here's a chance for Panarin. He scores! Artemi Panarin! He wins it in overtime! Oh, baby, what a finish!
They had to win a faceoff.
Oh, what an incredible game and an incredible finish. And the Rangers win in overtime. 2-1.
This is unbelievable.
Oh, man.
How did that happen? Off the face.
Artemi Panarin with his first goal of the season.
Oh, boy. Off the face-off. Zibanejad, instead of going backwards, goes forward to win it and then just dishes it off. Puts it over on the side for Panarin to put it in. They hadn't won a faceoff since halfway through the first period. They win that one and win it in overtime.
And the Rangers ought to carry Shesterkin off on their shoulders. What an effort by Shesterkin. And then Panarin, look at him jump.
You know what, Sam? I give a lot of credit to Zibanejad. They were absolutely dominated on faceoffs the whole game. And he said, I'm going to try something different. So he goes forward with it instead of going backwards, which most centers try to do on faceoffs. And he goes forward, gets control of it, and feeds Artemi Panarin for the game winner.
At 3:48 of overtime, the Rangers jump for joy. They win it 2-1. Artemi Panarin with a game winner. We'll be right back.